Okay. Now he did one more thing. Instead, he kept the magnet steady and he moved the coil. Okay.
When magnet was held steady and the coil was moved, the galvanometer got deflected and again produced a current.
Now, what was that telling him? It was neither the magnet nor the coil movement that was producing the current, it was the relative movement between the coil and the magnet that was actually responsible for the current. Okay?
So, thus, the relative motion of the coil and the magnet
Now we'll go to his second experiment.